Students, welcome back to our online class. What all things we discussed in our last class? We discussed about the data structure known as stack, and we also studied what is a stack and what all are the basic operations of a stack. Then we discussed how can we implement a stack using a Python program. That all things we discussed in our last class. Today we are going to see about what all are the applications of a stack. So, for what all purpose we can use a stack? That is the thing we are going to study today. So, these are the four basic applications of a stack. First one is reversing a string. Second one is conversion of infix expression to postfix expression. Third one is evaluation of a postfix expression. And the last one is evaluation of prefix expression. So, the last three application we need to discuss in detail. So, first one is what? First one is reversing a string. So, what is the basic operation of a stack? We can say that insertion and the deletion takes place at one end known as the top of the stack. So, in order to reverse a string, we can use a stack. So, suppose this is our string, that is ANSIA, my name. So, we need to reverse the string ANSIA, and for that purpose we can use a stack. So, this is our stack. So, what is our first operation? Our first operation is we push the entire characters of the string into the stack. So, at 0 index, letter A will be stored, then at index 1, N will be stored. Like that, we store the entire characters of our string into a stack. So, for that purpose, we will call which function? We will call the push function of the stack. After pushing the entire elements into the stack, we can directly call the pop function. So, while calling the pop function, what will happen? First of all, the top element will be popped out, which means letter A will be popped out. Then, which letter will be popped? Y will be popped, then I, then S, then N, then A. Now, while looking into the popped out elements, we can see that it is the reverse of their input string. In this way, we can reverse a string. So, what is the first application of this stack? In order to reverse a string, we can use a stack. So, in order to perform the reverse of any particular string, we can call our stack. Now, we need to see what is an infix expression, prefix expression and postfix expression, and how can we implement the remaining three applications of a stack. Before move on to the next application of this stack, we can discuss about polish strings. So, suppose we have an expression A plus B. Then, what do you mean by A and B? We will call A and B as operands of the expression, and plus is the operator of the expression. So, what is A and B? We will call it as operands, and this plus as operator. Now, look into the expression A minus C into B. So, what is the operands here? A, C and B are the operands of this particular expression. And minus and into are the operator of the given expression. Now, we can see what is meant by infix expression, prefix expression and the postfix expression. If the operator is placed in between the operands, such an expression is called an infix expression. So, that is the expression we use in our daily life. So, A plus B is an infix expression. Why? Because the operator plus is placed in between the operands A and B. So, in case of any expression, if the operator is placed between the operands, such an expression is called an infix expression, and we use it in our day-to-day life. Then comes the prefix expression and the postfix expression. This prefix expression and the postfix expression are called polished strings. Polished string means a polished way to represent the given expression. So prefix expression and postfix expression, or prefix notation of an expression and postfix notation of an expression, are called the polished strings. Then what do you mean by prefix expression? Prefix expression means the operator is placed before the operands, which means first of all the operator comes, then only the operands come. So according to the given infix expression a plus b, what is its equivalent prefix expression? So what is our rule? First of all the operator need to place. So what is the operator here? Plus, and after that the operands needs to place. So what are the operands here? A and b. So plus ab is the prefix expression of the infix expression a plus b. Next is postfix expression. Postfix expression means the operator is placed after the operand. So first of all the operands come, then only the operator comes. Such an expression is called postfix expression. So what is the postfix expression of the infix expression a plus b? So what is our rule? First of all the operands needs to write. So what are the operands here? A and b. So a b, after that the operator need to write. What is our operator here? Plus. So ab plus is the postfix expression of the infix expression a plus b. So what are all of the polished strings? Expressions can be write in three ways. What are they? Infix, prefix and the postfix. Infix is the normal way. What does it mean? The operator is placed between the operands. Prefix and postfix are called polished strings. Prefix means the operator is placed before the operands, and postfix means the operator is placed after the operands. Now look into this example. A minus C into B. So by looking into the given expression, it is clear that it is an infix expression. Now we need to find out the prefix and postfix equivalent of this given expression. So first of all I am writing the prefix expression of the given expression. So what is our rule? Here we can see a bracket. So first of all we need to convert this into prefix. So according to the rule, the minus symbol should come first, and after that the operands AC should come into B. Now this is the first operand and this is the second operand and this is our operator. Here we already convert it into prefix form. Then this will become our first operand and this will become our second operand and this is our operator. What is our rule? Operator should come first. So star sign should come first and after that the operand should come. So what is the first operand here? Minus AC. Then what is the second operand here? B. So into minus ACB is the prefix expression of the infix expression A minus C into B. Next is the postfix form of the given expression. So postfix form means what? Postfix form means first of all you need to write the operands then the operator. So infix expression is A minus C into B. First I am converting this bracket into postfix form. Then what will happen? First of all operands need to write. So AC and after that the operator. What is the operator here? AC minus into B. Now this becomes our first operand and this becomes our second operand and this becomes our operator. So according to the rule of the postfix form, the operands should come first. So what will happen? A, C, minus, this is our first operand, then second operand comes, that is B, and after that the into sign will come. In this way we can find out the prefix and postfix form of any infix expression. So if the expression contains greater number of operands and operator, some error may occur while writing it in this form. So using a stack we can easily find out the postfix form of any infix expression. Now we can see how can we find out the postfix expression of any given infix expression using a stack. Now what is our second application of stack? Our second application is conversion of an infix expression to postfix expression. That is the second application of a stack. And we now studied what is meant by an infix expression and what is meant by a postfix expression. Now the postfix expression is also known as suffix expression. So another name of postfix expression is suffix expression. So in the question paper, the question may be like this: convert the given infix expression to postfix expression. Or the question may be also like this: convert the given infix expression to suffix expression using a stack. So there is an algorithm to convert any given infix expression to postfix expression. Before moving on to that, we can discuss about the operator precedence. So in our given expression, it may consist of a number of operators. And now we can see what is the precedence order of each of the operator. Why we are using precedence order? In mathematics, we studied about word marks. And if our expression consists of a number of operations like this, that is bracket of division, multiplication, addition and subtraction, this rule will give which operation needs to perform first. So according to mathematics, bracket of should come first, then only division, then multiplication, then addition and then only subtraction. Like that, the operator precedence while converting an infix expression to postfix expression is the following. First of all, bracket, second exponent. So exponent simple can be 2 into simple may denote an exponent symbol, or this arrow symbol also denote an exponent symbol. Then comes multiplication and division. So multiplication and division has same precedence. Next is addition and subtraction. Addition and subtraction also has same precedence. Next is NOT. NOT means logical NOT. Next is logical and logical OR. So what is the precedence order of the operators while converting an infix expression to postfix form? Bracket, exponent, multiplication and division has same precedence. Then comes addition and subtraction. Then logical NOT. Then logical and last one is logical OR. Now we can see the algorithm to convert an infix expression to postfix form. Now look into the algorithm to convert an infix expression to postfix expression. So in this algorithm, we are using a stack to convert the given infix expression to postfix expression. Let us evaluate how the algorithm works. So we have a given infix expression, and according to the first rule, add a left parenthesis and a right parenthesis to both end of the given expression. So what is our first rule? Just add a left and right parenthesis to both end of the given expression. Second rule is scan the expression from left to right. So what is our second rule? Scan the given expression from left end to the right end. And while scanning, if a left parenthesis is encountered, push it to stack. So what is our rule? If a left parenthesis comes while scanning the expression, directly push it to stack. Second one is if an operand is encountered. So while scanning the expression, what all things may come? First of all, a left or right parenthesis may come. Then sometimes operand may come and sometimes operators may come. So if an operand comes, what is our rule? Add it to the postfix expression. So if an operand is come, directly add it to the postfix expression. So operands means what? Letters like A, B, C, etc. That all are called operands. Next is if an operator op is encountered, what will happen? So if an operator comes and the operator is denoted by op, what will happen? If the existing operator on stack has a precedence greater than or equal to our operator, pop it one by one from stack and add it to POSIX expression. So, when an operator comes, what is our rule? Just look into our stack. And if the stack has operators that has a greater or equal precedence of the operator or, then pop each of that operator from the stack and add it to our POSIX expression. Then what will happen? Then push our operator to stack. So what is the rule when an operator comes? When an operator comes, look into the stack. And if a stack has an operators which has greater or equal precedence of this operator, then pop the existing operators from the stack and add it to POSIX expression. After that, add our operator to stack. Then, last, if a right parenthesis is encountered, if a right parenthesis comes, what is our rule? Pop each of the element from the stack one by one. Elements means if it is an operator or if it is an operand, pop each of the element from the stack up to where until a left parenthesis is encountered and add it to POSIX expression. Then finally remove that left parenthesis from the stack. Last step is repeat the step 2 for each of the element of the given infix expression. So now the algorithm will be clear with the help of some examples. So these are our rules. Now look into our example. So our given infix expression is A plus B. And what is our first step? Add a left and right parenthesis to the given infix expression. So here I am adding a left parenthesis as well as a right parenthesis. Then second rule is what? Second rule is scan the expression from left to right. So we need three columns. The first column is simple scan. Second one is stack and third one is POSIX expression. So this POSIX column gives our final answer. So what is our rule? Scan the simples from left to right. For easiness, I am scanning the entire simple. So first of all, a left parenthesis, then A, then plus sign, then B, then right parenthesis. Then look into each of the simple and according to our rule, perform the operation. So first one is a left parenthesis. So if a left parenthesis is encountered, what is our rule? Push it to stack. So I am pushing the left parenthesis to the stack. Next is if an operand is encountered. So what is A? We know that these simples are called the operator and the letters like A, B and C are called the operand. So if an operand is encountered, add it to the POSIX expression. So I am adding this A to the POSIX expression. Now what is in the stack? The stack consists of a left parenthesis. So it is clear, if a left parenthesis encountered, add it to stack. If an operand is encountered, add it to the POSIX expression. Now the stack remains the same. Next is if an operator is encountered. We know that plus is an operator. So if an operator is encountered, what is our rule? Look into the stack whether it consists of any other operator. Now look into our stack. So our stack doesn't contain any other operator. So if the stack doesn't contain any other operator, just ignore this first rule and we follow the second rule. What is our second rule? Push off to stack. So what is our operator here? Plus sign and pushing it to stack. And what is remaining in the POSIX expression? The POSIX expression just consists of A only. Then again B comes. What is B? We know that B is an operand. So when an operand comes, what is our rule? Add it to POSIX expression. So I am adding B also to the POSIX expression. Now what is in our stack? Our stack consists of a left parenthesis as well as a plus sign. Now a right parenthesis is encountered. So what is the rule when a right parenthesis comes? When a right parenthesis comes, pop each of the elements from the stack. So pop all the elements from the stack, whether it is an operator or an operand until a left parenthesis is encountered and add it to the postfix expression. So what is our postfix expression now consists of? It consists of a, b, and our stack consists of a plus sign then a left parenthesis. So until a left parenthesis come, pop all the elements from the stack and add it to postfix expression. So I'm adding this plus sign to postfix expression. Why? Because when a left parenthesis comes, only plus sign exists in the stack. That is why I pop it to the postfix expression and then ignore the left parenthesis. So I'm ignoring the left parenthesis. Now our stack is empty and we scan the entire symbols of the given nfix expression. So what is our answer? Our answer is AB plus. So we can say that the postfix expression of the given infix expression is what? It is AB plus. So if you perform the algorithm in the correct manner, then what will happen? While completing the entire operation, the stack will become empty and the last line of the column postfix expression will give our answer. So we can say that AB plus is the postfix expression of the given infix expression A plus B. So first of all, you need to understand the algorithm very well. So question may not ask to write the algorithm. The question is convert the given infix expression to postfix expression using a stack. So when you know the algorithm very well only, you can perform the operation. And now we can look into some more. Now look into one more example. So the question is convert the given infix expression a minus b into c by d plus e to postfix expression using a stack. Then what is our rule? First of all, you need to draw three columns. First consists of simple scan, second stack, and third one is postfix expression. And according to our first rule, I am adding a left and right parenthesis to the given infix expression. Then second rule is what? Scan the simples from left to right. So first simple is a left parenthesis, again a left parenthesis. So never get confused between left parenthesis and C. So these are left parenthesis. Then comes A, then comes minus sign, then comes B, then a right parenthesis, then into sign, again left parenthesis, then C, then comes what? Division, D, right parenthesis, plus E. So these are our symbols. So I scan the entire symbols from left to right and put into the column simple scan. Now according to the rule, we need to find out what are the operations to perform while scanning each of the symbols. So first one is a left parenthesis. So when a left parenthesis comes, what is our rule? Push it to stack. So I am pushing it to our stack. Again a left parenthesis. So what is our rule? Push it to stack. So this is our first left parenthesis and this is our second left parenthesis. Then what is next? Next is an operand. So when an operand comes, what is our rule? Add it to postfix expression. So I am adding A to postfix expression. Now what is in our stack? Our stack consists of two left parentheses. Then what is next? Next a minus sign. So the things to remember is what to do with the operator and the right parenthesis. Remaining two are easy. When a left parenthesis come, push it to stack. When an operand come, add it to postfix expression. So what are the things to remember? What to do when an operator comes and what to do when a right parenthesis come. So here comes an operator, that is minus sign. So when an operator comes, first of all you look into our stack whether it consists of any other operator. So our stack doesn't contain any other operator. So ignore the first rule. Then what is our second rule? Push our operator to stack. So what is our operator here? It is a minus sign. So I am pushing it to stack. Why I ignore our first rule? Because our stack doesn't contain any other existing operator. So what is in the postfix expression now? It consists of A. then B comes. So what is B? B is an operand. So whenever an operand comes, add it directly to the postfix expression. Then what happen? Then a right parenthesis comes. So what is the rule when a right parenthesis comes? When a right parenthesis comes, pop the elements from the stack until up to where? Until a left parenthesis is encountered. So first of all, we can see the stack top contains a minus sign. So I am popping it to postfix expression. Then a left parenthesis comes. So here I am stopping the popping operation and then ignore our left and right parenthesis. So I am removing this left parenthesis. So what is remaining in the stack? The stack now consists of only a left parenthesis. Then an into sign comes. So whenever an into sign comes, look into our stack whether it consists of any other operator. Our stack doesn't contain any other operator. So I am adding this into sign into stack. Now, what is remaining in the postfix expression? It consists of AB minus. Again what? Again a left parenthesis comes. So, when a left parenthesis comes, add it to stack. And the postfix expression consists of AB minus. Then what comes? Then a C comes. What is C? C is an operand. So, when an operand comes, what to do? Add it directly to the postfix expression. Now our stack contains bracket into bracket. Now a division simple comes. So whenever an operator comes, look into our stack. So I am looking into our stack whether it consists of any existing operator with precedence greater than or equal to our operator. So what is our operator? Our operator is a division simple. I am looking into the stack. So what is our elements in the stack? A left parenthesis, into sign, and again a left parenthesis. So it consists of a multiplication sign that has same precedence as that of the division symbol. But here I can't pop it and add it into the postfix expression. Why? Because it is not at the top of the stack. So the stack top, the stack top now contains a left parenthesis. In order to remove the left parenthesis, a right parenthesis must come. Then only we can remove the left parenthesis. If the left parenthesis is not here, then when the division symbol comes, what is our rule? AB minus C. Then pop the into symbol into the postfix expression and add the division symbol to the stack. Here a left parenthesis is there at the top of the stack. So I can't remove the into sign from the stack. So ignore our first rule and what is our second rule? Add the division symbol to stack. Now what is remaining in the postfix expression? AB minus C. Then what happened? Then D comes. So D is an operand. Now I am adding it directly to the postfix expression. Again a right parenthesis comes. So what is the rule when a right parenthesis comes? When a right parenthesis comes, pop the elements from the stack until a left parenthesis is encountered. So here we can see a left parenthesis. Now I am popping this division symbol from the stack and adding it to the postfix expression and ignore the left parenthesis. So I am ignoring this left parenthesis. I pop the division symbol from the stack and add it to postfix expression and I remove the left parenthesis from the stack. Now the stack consists of a bracket as well as an into sign. Then a plus symbol comes. So here when we encounter an operator, look into our stack. I am looking into my stack and it consists of a left parenthesis and an into sign. So what is our rule? If the existing operator in the stack has a precedence greater than that of the coming operator, pop the operator from the stack and add it to postfix expression. So here we know that our operator is a plus sign and the existing operator in the stack is into sign. We know that into has a precedence greater than that of plus sign. So what is our rule? remove it from the stack and add it to POSIX expression. So I am adding into to POSIX expression, and after that push our operator to stack. So the rule is, whenever an operator comes, first of all it will add to the stack only, and the rule is check whether the stack consisting of any other operator that has a precedence greater than that of the coming operator. Here we can see into sign has a precedence which is higher than that of plus sign. Then what is our rule? Pop that existing operator from the stack and add it to POSIX expression, then add the plus sign to the stack. Next, what happened? Next, E. That is an operand, E comes. So what is our rule? Add it to POSIX expression. So I am writing here AB minus CD division into E. Now our stack consists of a left parenthesis and a plus sign. So what is our last thing? Our last thing is a right parenthesis. So when a right parenthesis come, what is our rule? Pop each of the element from the stack until a left parenthesis is encountered. So I am popping the minus sign from stack. So AB minus CD division into E. So I am popping the plus sign from the stack and add it to the POSIX expression and remove the left parenthesis. So here we can say that our stack is empty at this stage, and the POSIX expression consists of AB minus CD division into E plus. So we can say that this is the POSIX expression of the given infix expression A minus B into C by D plus E. What is the POSIX expression? AB minus CD division into E plus. In this way, we can convert any infix expression to POSIX form. Now, I am giving you some homework. Convert these two infix expression to POSIX form. So, what is the first question? True and false, or not, false or true. So, while looking into the question itself, we can see that what all are the operators, and, or, not, or are the operators, which means here we are using the logical operators, and we know the precedence of the logical operators. What comes first? Not, then and, then or. And this true false become our operands. So is it clear? True, false, false, true becomes our operand. And what are the operators according to this question? And, or, not, or. And the second question is A plus B to C minus, this is a left parenthesis, B by E exponent F, then right parenthesis into G, right parenthesis into H. So this is our question. Convert these two infix expression to POSIX form. So what all things we studied today? We study about the application of stack, and we discuss the first two application of the stack. That is, how can we reverse a string using a stack? Second one is, how can we convert an infix expression to POSIX expression using a stack. This is conversion, that is infix to POSIX conversion, is very, very important. There will be a sure question from this topic. So that's all for today. Thank you.